From a distance, it appears like business is as usual this Easter Monday at Arua Park, a major trade hub in Kampala serving northern route to Juba in South Sudan. Loaded on the trucks are household items, some of which are being re-exported to South Sudan. The road to either side of the border with South Sudan at Oraba in Koboko and Mule in Amuru district will take the loaded trucks well over 10 hours.
Gari ya Arua Park anaweza kumi na moja per day. Na tembea yote iko Limule. Sasa wakasoma mwenye natoka Sudan iko hapa mingi hawezi lala hotel. Sasa unaleta vitu anampa kwa kampuni.
The truckers are hoping that authorities will have found a solution to the killings by militias operating south of Juba by the time the lorries arrive at the border. This after 5 Ugandans were killed days ago and the trucks torched.
As of now, all trucks we have decided to park on Uganda side so that we can solve this problem of killing our drivers.
Trucks have clogged at Nimule.
The line which they make from Elegu border is up to Bibia, which is very far.
120 trucks crossing Elegu to Juba every day. But as of now, we have about 10 to 15 trucks which are stuck in southern Sudan on this side of Oraba.
The exports to South Sudan from Uganda mainly farm produce and re-exported products. According to the World Bank, Uganda earned $356 million in export revenue in 2018. The country saw export receipts grow to $364 million in 2019, according to Uganda Exports Promotion Board. The 2020 statistical data by Trend Economy shows the value of the exports dropped again to $357 million last year.
Represents one of our biggest markets as a country. So having this kind of instability happening in South Sudan is not good at a time when our trade with Rwanda is almost nil, and also at a time when we're having conflicts with Kenya.
All the eyes are now facing the state authorities for a collaborative joint security patrol along the routes.
Sudan should also appreciate that as a young country, they cannot build up capacity overnight. They have to depend on their neighbors. The way that Uganda has worked cooperatively with Kenya and built up its capacity over time, we've not had to kill Kenyan traders because they were taking advantage of our market in the early 80s.
Sources at the Ministry of Trade, Industries and Cooperatives indicate a crisis meeting is underway at the ministry with their colleagues at the foreign affairs sector. Jackson Onyango, NTV.